This video will explore a really interesting new data set for summarizing scientific papers about machine learning with machine learning. The too long didn't read summary is a case of extreme summarization. Given a research paper, which is on average about 10 pages in length, this task produces a one-sentence summary of the novelty of the paper. This task is additionally challenging because it requires domain expertise to understand what the novelty of a paper like this is. Deep learning models require massive amounts of data to learn from. The authors from the Allen Institute of Artificial Intelligence devise a clever way to gain additional data for this task from peer-reviewed comments of the paper. They benchmark their dataset using Facebook AI's BART model. This video will also explain the BART research as well, such as how BART is an intermediary between Google's BERT and OpenAI's GPT and different denoising objectives explored in BART. You can try this model out for yourself on the Allen Institute's NLP demo apps page by pasting in an abstract, introduction, and conclusion and seeing what the model comes up with. This video will explain the Too Long Didn't Read dataset, developed by researchers at the Allen Institute for Artificial Intelligence. The goal of this dataset is to train models that can automatically write one-sentence summaries of complex machine learning papers. The researchers also provide baseline results with a pre-trained BART language model on this dataset. This video will also present some of the details behind that BART model from Facebook AI and how it bridges modeling differences between Google's BERT and OpenAI's GPT. A too long didn't read summary is an example of extreme summarization, where we have this entire 8 to 10 page machine learning research paper and we're trying to summarize it into one sentence, such as we develop a new topological complexity measure for deep neural networks and demonstrate that it captures their salient properties. So this one sentence captures this idea that there's some new measure introduced in the paper, and then the experiments demonstrate that it does this kind of thing. So these summaries are used to help people gauge their interest in a paper and decide whether it relates to their own research. The TLDR dataset contains 3,935 of these one-sentence summaries corresponding with the research paper. They also use this interesting technique with the OpenReview.net platform to use the peer review comments to get additional TLDR summaries for the test set. The authors turn to the peer review comments in order to get more TLDR summaries for a given paper because it's easier than having an author write many different variations of the same paper, and it's an easier way for them to get more data for the sake of evaluating these models and performing this task. So an example of this is from this paper, Large Batch Optimization for Deep Learning, Training BERT in 76 minutes. You can see how the commenter starts off with, this paper presents a range of methods for overcoming the challenges of large batch training with transformer models. So all of these reviews from the reviewers at the ICLR conference have this kind of, they summarize the paper as well. So the authors of this paper show that you can use these peer-reviewed summaries to get more TLDR examples. Summarization with natural language processing models has mostly been tested on these news datasets, such as the CNN or Daily Mail datasets, where you have these news articles and then you try to distill them into two sentences or so to describe the news article. So an interesting detail about this Science Too Long Didn't Read dataset is that it has a really high compression ratio compared to most of these other summarization datasets. So you see that you're going from these massive document lengths into these one sentence summaries of them. So the compression ratio is a part of what makes this task extreme summarization and different from a lot of previous approaches at summarization. And then within summarization, there are two different sort of avenues of it. There's abstractive summarization and then extractive summarization. This is a case of abstractive summarization, where you're not just taking out a sentence from the original paper, you're rather writing something new that isn't already contained in the paper. Extractive summarization, which is baseline in this paper as the oracle, would be where you're extracting an exact sentence from the paper that best summarizes it. The authors benchmarked the TLDR dataset with Facebook's BART model, denoising sequence-to-sequence pre-training for natural language generation, translation, and comprehension. From the original BART paper, here are some examples of summaries that are created by this model. Now again, this is an abstractive summarization model, meaning that this model is writing new things about the source documents. It's not just taking out a single sentence or a set of words that describes the original set of documents best. So you see these different summarizations that are produced from the BART model. And again, most of these datasets that summarization have been tested on are these news article datasets. BART gets its name from being a bidirectional autoregressive transformer model. And this is bridging Google's BERT with the bidirectional context and GPT's autoregressive way of structuring generation with natural language tasks, where you have this autoregressive way of putting this mask over. So say at this step, you get as input A, B, you predict C, then the mask is over D, then you predict D, and so on. So this is this idea of autoregressive language generation. So BART has this encoder, which has the same kind of structure as BERT, where you have this input sequence and then intermediate corruptions to the sequence, and it's trying to reconstruct the sequence, and the decoder is going to get as input this kind of masked autoregressive thing, and it's going to predict the next token in an autoregressive way, but it's going to attend on the hidden representations in the BERT encoder half of the model. So you have the encoder side, this bidirectional context, and then you have the autoregressive decoder. So BART has this natural architecture that makes it successful at doing the task that BERT is really good at and the task that GPT is really good at. And this is why BART is kind of the strong baseline right now for doing summarization tasks. So it's interesting to think about language models as denoising autoencoders. We take in an original sequence that's been corrupted in some way with some noise, and then we look at how we can pass it through this encoding and then reconstruct the original input after it's been denoised through the autoencoder. So it's interesting to bridge these kinds of areas of research with the BERT model and then denoising autoencoders. When you're designing these denoising autoencoders, there are many different ways to set up the noise that you apply to the input such that it makes the denoising autoencoder task. Imagine an image autoencoder. We might take the image and then randomly add some Gaussian noise to it, or crop out an entire rectangle of the image to corrupt the image as input to our denoising autoencoder. In language, we have these kinds of noise corruptions. Token masking is the most popular. This is this idea from BERT where you randomly select a token and then replace it with the mask token. Token deletion would be where you randomly delete a word in the sequence. Text infilling is this idea similar to span BERT, where instead of just deleting one token, we're going to delete a sequence of tokens. And one thing that's different about this paper, BART, compared to, say, span BERT, is the distribution with which they apply these span deletions. So they have a Poisson distribution for having how long you're going to delete the sequence of, compared to other distributions of how you set up how long the span is going to be that you're going to delete. But then you also have sentence permutation, which is similar to the XLNet paper, where you take a sentence and then you scramble the order of the tokens, and the denoising autoencoder objective is to reconstruct the original sequence. And this makes more sense for language. You can imagine if you try to do this with an image, randomly scramble all the pixels, it would be completely impossible for the model to reconstruct the original image. And then you have document rotation. Document rotation is where you rotate it such that the start comes at the end and then it moves it this way, and then you try to have it reconstruct where the start of the document is. And this can be really useful for summarization tasks to help it understand this kind of structure of start and end of a scientific research paper. The BART paper takes apart different ways of structuring the architecture and these different pre-training ways of corrupting the denoising autoencoder objective. What they show is that there's a difference between performance in, say, text classification and then natural language generation. You see in the case of the Explain It Like I'm 5 dataset, which is a summarization dataset, the left-to-right autoregressive language model performs much better than, say, the mass language model is in BERT. So what BART is really good at is combining the bidirectional context and the capabilities of left-to-right autoregressive generation that are really good for producing things like summaries, or if it's like a chatbot or something, you'd want this left-to-right autoregressive structure to be in the model. These are some examples of the previous datasets that have been explored in the abstractive summarization literature. Explain It Like I'm 5 has this question like, how do jellyfish function without brains or nervous systems? And has to answer it simply given these source documents. The extreme summarization dataset is one of these examples of really compressing the source document, similar to this TLDR dataset, although not quite as extreme as this dataset is. But you see how you take this document and then you summarize it in like one or two sentences. So it's much more compressed of a source to output representation. And then you have the CNN Daily Mail summarization task. This is the most commonly reported summarization data set in the natural language processing literature. So then you can see the comparison with respect to the size of the data set. You see that so far this TLDR data set is much smaller than the others, although it is much more specialized. This is all going to be these machine learning research papers that are taken from OpenReview compared to like news articles that can vary enormously in what they're talking about. Then you see the comparison of the document length, then the summarization length, which is the output target, and the compression ratio. So in extreme summarization, they don't have this massive document to be summarized from compared to a full research paper. But the authors of TLDR are going to further compress this by looking at writing a TLDR just from the abstract or just from the abstract introduction and conclusion, because research papers all follow this kind of setup of abstract introduction, then maybe related works or experiments. they have this set structure that helps break up how you're going to design these tasks. The BART research paper has this list of lessons from their pre-training and architecture ablations. They find the performance of pre-training methods varies significantly across tasks. You're not going to have the same exact setup for the SuperGLUE benchmark as for the Explain It Like I'm 5 question answering, kind of abstractive question answering model. Token masking is a crucial pre-training objective that seems to almost always improve the performance. The left-to-right pre-training is a way of improving generation capability. Bidirectional encoders are crucial for the Stanford question answering dataset, where you have that bidirectional context and you're picking out a section of the document that answers the question. And the pre-training objective isn't the only important factor. The pure language models perform best on Explain It Like I'm 5, showing that left-to-right model has the best result on this dataset. And then BART, this combination of the bidirectional and the autoregressive language modeling, achieves the most consistently strong performance. The authors are taking on the TLDR dataset with the pre-trained BART language model. So the first thing to note about this is that the pre-trained BART model has a fixed input sequence length, or a maximum of the input sequence length. So as we saw previously, this TLDR dataset is trying to summarize these entire research papers. So what they need to do is compress this because it can't attend over this massive sequence. This is the idea behind recent research like sparse attention, the reformer, the longformer, or memory augmented ways like transformer XL or compressive transformer. They're looking at ways such that you can attend over a longer sequence. But as of right now, this attention calculation has this quadratic complexity such that you have a limit to how much of the input sequence you can attend over. So they truncate the TLDR dataset by only using either the abstract or the abstract introduction and conclusion as input to the model rather than the entire research paper. So then the next thing they do is their pre-training pipeline goes from the XSum dataset, which has about 200,000 of these source target pairs, into their TLDR, and they're adding another task to get more data for more supervision for these for this task. So they have these control codes, TLDR or title, and they use this to control what task the language model is to be performing. So title is just given the abstract, predict the title of the paper, compared to writing this one sentence summary of it. So it's definitely an interesting additional task that provides more supervision to the model. Summarizing long documents like research papers motivates research into models that have longer range memory. This is a really interesting model, the compressive transformer, introduced by DeepMind, that might be able to extend this idea of BART. So what happens in DeepMind's compressive transformer is that as it attends on a previous sequence, it'll store this activation in memory. So say this is a sequence of length 512, it'll store those past activations, and then it'll write that to a compressed memory of all the previous input sequence lengths that it had seen. This is one interesting architecture to have this longer range attention. In addition to introducing this model, they also introduced this new dataset, which is this PG-19 books dataset, where you need more context in order to do that predict the next token language modeling task. Another interesting area of research on this is generating Wikipedia by summarizing long sequences. You can see a full video explanation of this paper on Henry AI Labs as well. So what they do in this case is they have all the different cited Wikipedia articles and all of the referenced articles as the input, and then the output is to generate the Wikipedia article. But again, this is a case of trying to attend over a massively long input sequence. So they have this pipeline of extractive summarization as to feed more input into the abstractive summarization model. So they use extractive to try to take the most salient information from this massive input, and that goes as the input into the transformer decoder that is the abstractive summarization model. And they also introduce this memory compressed attention to try to break up this problem of quadratic complexity with attention over these input sequences and attend over longer sequences. Another interesting area of natural language processing is text-to-text, text-as-input, text-as-output language models. But I think this summarization task might kind of explode the input length that these models need to be used to handling. So imagine you have a task like translate English to German and then a short sequence like that. If this model is also going to be capable of doing summarize and then an entire research paper, you're going to have to like zero pad this input enormously in order to have it doing all these different tasks. So I think it's interesting to think about sort of the input cardinality or how long these input sequences are with respect to these different tasks. And maybe that kind of changes the way we should think about this text-to-text unifying framework for all NLP tasks. Another interesting area of deep learning more generally is graph neural networks. Now these graph neural networks could use things like the adjacency matrix of the citations of the research paper to get more information about how to write this one-line summary. So imagine we have these text features, which is the entire document, and those that raw text high dimensional input is then distilled into a lower dimensional representation with this BART model. And then it's combined with the adjacency matrix information, as well as the text embeddings of these other research papers that are being cited in this research paper. So having this kind of context graph, sort of like the Cora citation data set, where you have this one paper, BART, and you see that BART cites GPT and BERT, that might help you get more information about how to summarize BART. Thanks for watching this overview of the TLDR, Extreme Summarization of Scientific Documents paper from the Allen Institute of Artificial Intelligence. This is a really cool application and an interesting data set for summarizing research papers into one-sentence summaries. The authors use a really clever technique of using the peer-reviewed comments to get additional training data or testing data for this model that can handle the diversity in these different one-sentence summaries of research papers. I hope also from this video you got a sense of the BART model and why it's used as a baseline for these summarization tasks. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to Henry AI Labs for more deep learning and artificial intelligence videos.